Hello, everybody! Our adventure around the year continues, and today we are arriving to the spring. Spring. So, let's begin. Messi's lesson of the week. Seasons. Времена года. Времена года. Весна. Весна. Spring. One more time. Весна. Весна. Spring. Весна. Весна – это хорошо. Весной хорошая погода. Тепло. Я гуляю. Я Месси, я звезда, я гуляю. Весна, весна – это хорошо. Весной хорошая погода, тепло. Я гуляю. Spring. Spring – it's good. It's always good. The weather is good in spring. The weather is good in spring. It's warm. I go for a walk. Весна! Весна! Тепло! Тепло! Герда тоже гуляет. Герда тоже гуляет. Мы бегаем. Мы бегаем. New verb. New verb of adventure, to run. Да? And of course, Герда over here, Герда, and Месси, and it's spring because it's the last snow of the spring and they are running. Мы бегаем. Мы бегаем. It's spring. It's warm. Герда goes for a walk too. We run. Here's our words for today's lesson. Весна. Весна. Spring. Весной. Весной. In the spring. You probably notice the commonality of all these adverbs. Зима – зимой. Осень – осенью. Весна – весной. The ending. This is the ending. Да? Осенью – весной – зимой. So that's what makes it a time of the year. Весной. In the spring. Это хорошо. Это хорошо. It's good. Погода. Погода. It's a very common word for the beginners because you really should be able to talk about the weather. Every time you meet somebody new, or Masha and Sasha, when they start their streams, they keep talking about weather, how it's warm outside or how it's cold or whatever, depending on the time of the year. So, let's say it one more time. Погода. Погода. Weather. Хорошая. Хорошая. Good. And it's feminine because, again, the adjective and the noun agree in gender. Погода is gender feminine, and that's why хорошая погода, it means good weather. Тепло, тепло, warm. Я гуляю, I go for a walk. You probably recognize that verb, but we use lots of it in our verbs of motion, but in the form of the infinitive. Я иду гулять. Я иду гулять. Same translation, I go for a walk. But now you understand that this verb, гулять, could be used as a standalone verb by itself because it does have its own meaning. Я гуляю, I stroll, I'm outside, I'm hanging out outside, I go for a walk. Я гуляю, я гуляю. Герда гуляет, Герда гуляет. So, this is the third person singular. Герда goes for a walk. Герда goes for a walk. Here is я гуляю, Герда гуляет, гуляет, гуляю, гуляет. I have not given you the full conjugation of this verb, just two, it's first person singular, я гуляю, and third person singular, Герда гуляет, гуляет. And this wonderful verb, мы бегаем, we run, and they do run. And here is Герда is run. Герда is running on her own. Герда is running on her own. So, Герда бегает. Герда бегает. Мы бегаем. Весна. Весна. Тепло. Тепло. Мы гуляем. Мы бегаем. I know that's a little bit out of order, but that's on purpose. I hope that you would be able to hear what I'm saying without looking at the screen and seeing that it's written. So just listening, let's sharpen our ears without being anchoring our eyes to the slide without written help to you. So мы бегаем, мы гуляем, мы бегаем, мы гуляем. That's how we are going to improve our listening comprehension. And this is the wonderful term of foreign language studies, listening comprehension and reading comprehension. You are doing great with reading, so let's see how your listening is. Just tell me what I'm saying, what I'm pronouncing without being attached to the written reinforcement on the screen. That's all, folks, for today. Hope you like the lesson. We'll take a look at summer tomorrow. Have a wonderful day. Всего хорошего. До завтра.